Hello everyone. In the Indian music system, when you are a performing artist, especially a vocal artist or an instrumentalist, it becomes very important that you understand the rhythmic structures or the tala system. In this video, we will be discussing the tala system, which is related to the Carnatic music system. You would be surprised to know that there are about 175 talas within the Carnatic music system. So in this video we will demonstrate how these 175 talas can be derived. So let's, without much delay, let's get into the, you know, the tala system. There are basic or fundamental 7 talas, which are called as the Suladi Satta talas. Suladi Satta talas, or these are the primordial or, you know, fundamental talas. And every tala has got 3 components, namely the laghu, a laghu is nothing but the counting of the fingers, which is after a clap. For example, sa ri ga ma, as in chatushra jati, that is 4 counts. Or we could have triputa tala, sa ri ga, just 3 counts. So basically it is the counting of the fingers, and this is denoted by the symbol 1. A laghu is usually followed by a dhrutam. A dhrutam is nothing but 2 beats. That is the demonstration, you know, just 2 counts, follow a beat followed by a reverse beat, and this is denoted by a 0. Dhrutam denoted by 0. There is also something called as the Anudhrutam. Anudhrutam, and the symbol is 0, and this is just a single beat, you know, just a single beat. So let's discuss now the 7 ragas, 7 talas. The first one is Dhruva Tala. In a Dhruva Tala, it is a laghu, a dhrutam, and then followed by 2 laghus. Now I won't tell you at this moment how many fingers or how many aksharas are there in every laghu, because that would be the topic of next next discussion. So in this, the laghu would be, for example, sarigama gari, sarigari, sarigama. So as you can see, if you add up all of these, it comes to 14 aksharas. So in Dhruva Tala, sa sa re ga ma ga ri sa re ga ri sa re ga ma, that would be the structure. So 14. Next, after Dhruva comes Matya Tala. Matya Tala. This is exactly like Dhruva Tala, except for the last laghu is not there. So, as you all might have guessed, it is 1, 0, just 1. There is no more 1. So basically, sarigama gari, sarigari. So that is the structure. Sarigama gari, sarigari. Or else we could even sing this as sarigama garis, sarigama regama pa maga regama pa. So this adds up to 10 aksharas. So this is Matya. After Matya, we have got Rupakam. Rupaka. So this starts with the drutam, followed by a laghu. So sari sari gama. So 0 and 1. I wouldn't be writing sari sari gama. It's understood. So this is rupakam, third. Fourth is jampa. Now this is a little different and complex. So this starts with the laghu, which is of 7 counts. Sari ga sari sari, 7. After that there is an anudrata, ga, followed by adrutam, ma. So sari ga sari sari ga ma. So it is a laghu which is of 7 counts, an anudrutam, sorry, u anudrutam, followed by adrutam. So this is jampa. So obviously this also adds up, very similar to our matya tala. This is also 10 aksharas. However, the rhythmical structure is very different. After this, we have got tripota tala. This is 1 0 0. However, this one over here, this laghu, is of 3 counts. That is sari ga sari ga ma re ga ma re ga ma pa. So 7 aksharas. After this we've got atta tala. So this is 1 1 0 0. However, here the laghu, each laghu is of 5 counts, 5 aksharas. This is 2 2. So this is also 14. So I give an example. Sa ri ga 5, sa ri ga 5, ma ma. So sa ri ga sa ri ga ma ma ri ga ma ri ga ma pa pa. So this is 14. And last one is the easiest one. It is called ekatala. Eka. This has got just one laghu. So it is just sa ri ga ma ri ga ma pa ga ma pa da. Just 4 counts. So here with this we conclude the 7 talas. Next we will be moving on to something called as the jatis. So now we have got the 7 talas. Now let me talk about the 5 jatis. There is Tishra jati. Tishra meaning 3. There is Chatushra jati. Chaturushra. That is 4. Kanda. Kanda is 5. Mishra 7. And Sankirna. Sankirna or 9. So Tishra is typically denoted as Takita. Chatushra is Takadhimi, 4. Khanda Takadakita, 5. Mishra Takadhimi Takita, 7. 4 plus 3. We could also sing Takita Takadhimi. And lastly, Sankirna. This is again 4 plus 5. Takadhimi Takadakita. Or 5 plus 4. Takadakita, 5. Or 5 plus Takadhimi. Takatakita, takadhimi, takatakita, takadhimi, taka. So this is Sankirana. Now how do we club these jatis into the thalas? Let me give you a very nice example. So if you remember the previous section, I spoke about a very simple talam called Triputa talam, which is 1 0 0. But back then I just asked you to assume that this laghu was 3, which means the complete answer for this would be Tishra Jati, because the whole these jatis are applicable only to the laghu and not the drutam, because druta is always 2. So as you can see, in the first section it was Tishra Jati Triputa Talam. Now let us just change this into 4. What do you get? Chatushra Jati Triputa Talam. In other words, this is Adi Talam. Because if the laghu becomes 4, what is it? Sa Ri Ga Ma followed by 2 zeros. Pa Da Ni Sa. So now this became Adi Talam. So Adi Talas actual name, the technical name would be Chatushra Jati Triputa Talam. We could also experiment with, let us say, I spoke about Dhruva Talam, which was 1 0 1 1. But back then I never specified what jati it was. So can you guess what jati it was? Sarigamagari Sarigari, only laghu. So I was singing Sarigamagari Sarigari Sarigama. It was Chatushra Jati Dhruva Talam. Shall we simply make this as say maybe Khanda Jati? Takka takita. It would be following that pattern, you know. Sariga sari sariga sariga, you know, something like that. So in that case it would become Khanda Jati Dhruva Talam. So that's how you will get 7 into 5 jatis, which is 35 basic talas. Now, however, we have also got something called as 5 gatis, that is the speed of the talam. So I will again, you know, the 5 gatis are also very similar to the 5 jatis. That is, name wise, they are Tishra Gati, Chatushra Gati. By the way, gatis are also called in Tamil literature as nadais. So most viewers who are not familiar with the word gatis, it's also called as nadai. Or in Kannada, it is called nade. So what are these 5 gatis? Tishra Gati, Chatushra Gati, Khanda Gati, Mishra Gati and Sankirana Gati. But why do we need these gatis? Gatis basically define not the beat, but the sub-beat. I will take a very simple example so that you will understand what is the concept. Now let us take Tishra Jati Triputa Talam. 1 0. So basically when I say Triputa Talam, the viewer should know that first you should write down the structure. Then you should ask what jati it is. So I said Tishra Jati. Tishra means only laghu is getting affected, 3. But when I say Tishra Jati Triputa Talam with Khanda Nadai, now here comes the beauty. So when I say Khanda Nadai, you know that Khanda Nadai is 5, right? So basically what we would be doing is Takita Taka Dhimi, correct? 1 2 3 Sariga Sarigama. However, in Khanda every single beat, Sariga Sarigama, for every single beat I will be singing a Khanda. Taka Takita Taka Takita. So it will become Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita. So as you can see, my main talam is Tishra Jati Triputa Talam. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. But for every beat I am singing Khanda. Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita Taka Takita. So 7 into 5, actually now it becomes 35 sub aksharas. So similarly we can do, you know, Triputa Talam, Tishra Jati, Or let's take a different Chatushra Jati, that is basically Adi Talam. Chatushra Jati Triputa Talam is Adi Talam. Instead of Kanda, we will make it Mishra, which is 7. So basically, you are singing Adi Talam with every beat. Takadimi Takita, 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 Takadimi Takita. So the pattern is very different. So every Takadimi Takita is 7, right? So 7 into 8, 56. It's got 56 Sabdaksharas. So this way, when you combine the 7 root talams with the 5 jatis and the 5 nadai, you get 175 talams. A note of mention. So there are also popular chapus. Now chapus were originally derived from, you know, folk music, semi-classical music. However, chapus have become today an integrated part of Carnatic system. In fact, there are swarajatis, kirtanis, everything in chapus. For example, chapus do not fall into this classic system. I'll give an example. A kanda chapu. So kanda is 5. But in kanda chapu, there is no dhritam, anudhritam. It just follows taka takita, taka takita. One popular composition is Paridanamichite palintuve, mo paridanamichite palintuve, mo paridan. So that would become kanda chapu. Mishra chapu would be takita takadimi. Krishna ni degani. Baro. So that would become Mishra Chapu. Similarly, we have got Sankirana Chapu. So that basically concludes an introduction into the Tala system within the Carnatic music system. If you have liked this video, do not forget to like this video and also subscribe to my channel. More interesting content is coming up very soon. Thank you.